So the last one is enable your application teams, right? And this goes back to the first ease of use one, right? These two are kind of tied together. App teams tend to have a stigma about central customer identity solutions, and you've got to break that mold, right? If you're offering a solution that's easy to use and that's going to help them launch faster and that's going to help them, you know, not have security and identity be such a burden for them, you can kind of sell that to them. You know, the stigma is that central IAM solutions, as you can see on the left, are too complex. They're not going to allow for them to customize their UX. They're going to have rigid data schemas. They're not going to have the customer IAM features we need, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Right. And from your perspective, if you allow them to just go choose their own solution, right, the cloud solutions they choose may not have, you know, support for on-prem applications or that hybrid IT coexistence that you need to do a real true cloud-first migration. Now, they may not have the reliability and security standards you need. They may not be able to model some of those existing things that you do have in your existing IAM solution that are really key, like a tenant-dependent architecture and the others that we talked about, right? So, you know, we're from Ping, and we've crafted a solution that we think checks all of these boxes, right? It not only makes it easy for development teams, but also checks the boxes for architects and for IT that ensure a secure and reliable IDaaS platform that's going to enable you to architect a more sophisticated identity infrastructure in the cloud and meet your security and reliability standards, right? So I'll say that whether or not you end up going with Ping solution as you make your cloud first migration, I think these standards that we've gone through in today's presentation hold true. And so I hope these have helped you regardless of the direction you go, you know, as you migrate to the cloud. But I think these things are really, really important to watch out for as you start mapping out your path to the cloud and you start enabling your application teams and business units to start using the solution that you